You are welcome to GST 104, the use of library. My name is Dr. Angela Ibele Okpala. Module 1, Unit 1, definition of a library. In the Librarian's Book of Lists, George Eberhardt defined library as a collection of resources in a variety of formats that is organized by information professionals or other experts who provide convenient physical, digital, bibliographic or intellectual access and offer targeted services and programs with the mission of educating, informing or entertaining a variety of audience and the goal of stimulating individual learning and advancing society as a whole. Types of libraries. There are basically 5 types of libraries: academic libraries, research/special libraries, school libraries, public libraries, and national libraries. Some authors, however, group school libraries together with academic libraries. Now let's look at academic libraries. These are libraries of academic institutions, such as universities, polytechnics, and colleges of education. The purpose of establishing these libraries is to meet the information needs of staff and students in the institutions they belong. Functions of academic libraries. Academic libraries provide research information resources in line with the needs of the staff and students. They provide information materials as required for the academic programs of the parent institutions. They provide information resources for recreation and for personal self-development of users. They provide specialized information services to appropriate sections of the larger community. They also cooperate with other libraries at appropriate level for improved and better information services. They provide conducive reading environment and facilities. Now let's look at research and special libraries. Research libraries are also special libraries. They are purposely established to cater for patrons with special and specific interests. Special libraries serve an identified group of users with common interests. They are privately owned and funded by the organizations that establish them. The resources of special libraries cover only particular subject area or group of subjects. Their subject area is usually defined from onset. The information supplied by these libraries to their patrons is usually comprehensive and up-to-date and mainly for research. Now let's look at the functions and services of research or special libraries. The functions and resources of library must be in line with library objective, primary objectives of the parent body of the library. The first function is to provide in-house training activities to new users and staff members alike. Provision and production of bibliographies. Provision of current awareness service, CAS, to the library clientele. A space must be allocated for CAS in the library for the exhibition of newly published materials. Provision of literature search. Selective dissemination of information, SDI. The librarian must know users' profile and send relevant information to them on their areas of interest. Provision of other supportive services, such as provision of photocopying, printing, and document delivery services. Interlibrary loans and network are also provided by special libraries. Special libraries perform some other internal and external services, such as writing of periodic reports, organizing conferences, seminars, talks for users and outsiders. Now let's have a look at school libraries. School libraries are the libraries that are established in schools. They are attached to primary and secondary schools. School libraries' main objective is to serve the educational needs of pupils, students, and teachers. Functions of school libraries. collection of relevant information resources that will enhance the performance of teachers as well as the pupils in order to achieve the aim and objectives of the school education. Development and creation in people's good reading habits. Help pupils to improve their vocabulary. Support academic or schoolwork. Help teachers and pupils to be current and up to date with daily information resources. Serves as a source of subject information center for both teachers and pupils. Help to train pupils in the use of reference materials. Now let's look at public libraries. Public libraries are libraries that are open to everybody in general and is generally accessible by the public. Its source of funding is public taxes and operated by civil servants. Functions and services of public libraries. Public libraries cater for the social, educational, and recreational needs of the community. They collect, preserve, and disseminate library resources suitable for the different categories of people, such as children, adults, illiterates, and literates. They usually engage in repackaging of information using audiovisual materials and indigenous languages to render information services to the literate class. They promote recreation and leisure reading. They promote the civic and cultural activities of the community. They create and strengthen reading habits in children from childhood. They support both individual and self-conducted education as well as formal education at all levels. They provide adequate information that will improve the knowledge and opinion of the masses. Finally, let's look at the national libraries. National libraries are specially established by the government of the nation to serve as the preeminent repository of information for that country. Unlike public libraries, national libraries rarely allow citizens to borrow books. The major mandate of national libraries is to serve as the library of the nation. Functions of national libraries. They act as legal depository and bibliographic center of the nation. They give advice on library development or organization to any agency of the federal, state, or local government. They have the responsibility of the rebuilding national bibliography and development of bibliographic services. The National Library of Nigeria, for instance, which is located at Abuja, plays a parental role to other libraries in Nigeria. It issues the international standard book number to publishers and authors of books. Thank you for listening.